So how do you install Fallout 4 mods with Nexus Mod Manager? That is what I'm going to show you in this video.
It's all over.
Now, if for some reason you've stumbled across this video because you want to mod Fallout 4, but you're not totally sure what Nexus Mod Manager is or what a mod manager is in general, I have actually done a video introducing Nexus Mod Manager, what it is and why we use it, and I would direct you to go and watch that. It will explain everything you need to know. However, assuming that you know that, we're going to start by covering the three things that you really do need to know before you start installing mods. The first thing you need to do is enable modding on Fallout 4. Now, I've actually done a video devoted to just this, but I will very quickly show you how to do it here. You're going to need to go along to your Documents folder, and in your Documents folder, go to My Games, Fallout 4. And you're looking for two INI files, Fallout 4 INI and Fallout 4 prefs.ini. You're going to need to make a couple of edits to those two files. First of all, I'll edit Fallout 4 prefs.ini. I'm going to use Notepad++, but you can use any text editor, including Notepad. And you're going to need to go down to the bottom and under the section marked Launcher, you need to add an option that says bEnableFileSelection equals 1. If you already have such an option, but it is set to 0, change it to 1. I will leave a copy of this command in the description down below so you can just cut and paste it into Fallout 4 prefs. Make sure you save that. Next, you're going to want to edit the Fallout 4 custom.ini file. And again, I'm going to use Notepad++. And you will need to add the following lines. Archive in square brackets, followed by bInvalidateOlderFiles equals 1, and sResourceDataDirsFinal equals, and nothing. I will leave a copy of these three lines in the description down below, so you can copy them and paste them into this file. Then you just save as you did before, and you're done. Now, if you find you cannot save it, it's refusing to save it, it says it's read-only, don't worry, just right-click on the file, go to Properties, and make sure read-only is not set. So if it looks like that, click it so it is not checked. Hit Apply and OK, then you will be able to make the edit. Please also note that occasionally people report that these two files do get refreshed when they do something, and it removes the edits they've made. So if all of your mods suddenly stop working one day, check those two edits. That is a very likely culprit. The second thing you're going to need is to know where your Fallout 4 data folder is. I have one. I have mine stored up here. And to help you find it, you're going to need to know where your Steam folder is. Now, I've installed Steam on a separate drive on games, but a lot of people will probably use the default location, which will be in the program files somewhere. Wherever it is, you need to find it, and you go to Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Fallout 4. This is the game folder. You'll know you're in the right place because it says Fallout4.exe and Fallout4Launcher.exe. Don't worry if you don't see the .exe. That just means your operating system is hiding those extensions from you. And the folder you're really interested in is the data folder. This is where you will find quite a lot of BA2 files and the Fallout4.esm file. This, you generally need to know where this is. This is where all of your mods are going to be placed. I'm going to leave this open. And thirdly, you're going to need Nexus Mod Manager installed, fairly obviously. You can actually find a link to Nexus Mod Manager at the top of the Fallout 4 Nexus page. Click on this link and basically click the correct button for you. If you're using XP, click this button. If you're using Vista, Windows 7, 8 or 10, click this button and it will download to wherever it is you want to download it to. It is not dangerous. It will not harm your computer, so I'm going to keep it. Mine has downloaded to my desktop. Once it's finished, just double-click and begin the installation process. Follow the instructions. It's relatively simple. It does explain everything as you go along. You should probably read all of the notes it gives you. And again, just follow the instructions. If you are a little nervous about this process, if you're not totally sure and you want a detailed description of how to install this tool and how to set it up for every eventuality, I have made a video devoted to just that, to getting Nexus Mod Manager set up perfectly, and you should probably go off and watch that. So, you've now got the game ready to be modded, you know where your data folder is, and you've got Nexus Mod Manager installed, and believe it or not, the hard part is over. That's the bulk of the work. The rest is pretty damned simple. So let's install our first mod. I'm going to actually choose Realistic Survival Damage mod. It's a simple mod that will change the damage done in survival mode, and it has a single file plugin. To install this with Nexus Mod Manager, all you need to do is go along to the File section and hit Download with Manager on the main file. It will take a second or so. Nexus Mod Manager will detect it and start to download. Once it's downloaded, it will appear in this tab. And to activate it, to actually make it work with your game, all you need to do is click this tick icon, install and enable the selected mod. It's actually now installed and it should be working. I will actually show you inside the data folder. There is now an ESP file called realisticsurvivaldamage.esp. Any mod with an ESP, and that is quite a few of the mods, it's a good idea to go along to the plugins section here and make sure that particular plugin is selected, Realistic Survival Damage. And that's it. You've literally just installed a mod and it should work just fine. To show you a different type of mod, I'm going to show you Value Per Weight Indicator for Container UI. This is a great mod that adds an extra row in the container UI that tells you the value to weight ratio. But it's a mod that doesn't have a plugin file. The ESP you saw for this. We're going to see what this does by installing it. I'm going to download the main file once more. And it's beat me to it. That's how small it was. It's already downloaded and added it to the tab. I am going to activate it, and I'll quickly check the plugins, and you'll see nothing has added. Don't worry, that's because this mod does not have a plugin. But if I go along to the data folder, you now see an interface folder. This is where the mod's files are. It's added two files. Now watch what happens if I deactivate this or disable it. It disappears. I will enable it once more, and the files come back. You can see how easy that is. As long as the mod has been packaged correctly by the mod maker, you should be able to install all of the mods that have this button, Download with Manager, that easily. Occasionally there will be a mod that is not that easy, and I will show you how to do that. But before I do that, I'm going to show you how to install mods that are from other sites or mods that you downloaded manually, even from Nexus Mod Manager. Occasionally you will find a mod that you have to download manually. I'm actually going to choose a mod that you don't have to download manually, but I'm going to download it manually anyway, just to show you the process. This is the No More Cache Register sound. You can actually download this the same way, but let's assume this is a mod you got from somewhere else and you've downloaded it manually. I'm going to download it to my desktop again. So I now have this mod. Mods always come packaged as either zips, RARs, or 7z files. These are archives. You should probably have a tool on your computer that will unpack RARs or 7z files, 7zip files, and I would suggest 7zip or WinRAR. They work perfectly. Now, there are two ways to add this mod to Nexus Mod Manager. You can, if you want, go along to the plus icon here, click it. It will ask you to find the file. I will go desktop and then choose no more cache register, and it will add it. It's that simple. But let me remove it because I'm going to show you an easier way. Take the file, drag it on, and there you go. Now I'm going to activate this. I'll move it down a little so you can see what appears in the data folder. Activate this. This time, some files appeared in a sound folder. Once more, no plugin to worry about for this particular mod. And that's it. You can now install mods from other sites. Now, there will be some mods that are a little more complicated than this, but I'm not going to cover them in this video. The mods I've shown you so far, the techniques you use to install those, should see you through a hell of a lot of mods. However, if you want to learn more about these complicated mods, or if you find a mod that is more complicated and you need help with it, I have made a video devoted to installing mods using Nexus Mod Manager. It goes into far more detail, and you can check that one out. I will leave a link down below. So, hopefully now you know how to set up your game so it can be modded, you know where the mods are going to be installed, and you know how to use Nexus Mod Manager to install those mods. And all that is left to do is wish you the best of luck in your modding endeavors. I hope you enjoy modding your game and, of course, playing the modded game. Feel free to join me on any of my future modding videos, or any of my past ones for that matter. You are more than welcome. I will, of course, look forward to seeing you on any such video. And until then, remember, as always, have fun.